and welcome to my channel. In this video, I'll be showing you two artificial reefs where I dived on my recent holiday to Bodrum Gambon in Turkey with Happy Bubbles Dive Center. Now, for this dive center, there's not actually I've got a shop. You have to go online, or you can meet them in one of the hotels and someone will have a chat. And if you booked, they will actually pick you up from the hotel. So on this particular dive, I had basically the boat to myself. There was two other divers that were doing an open water course. As you can see, the boat was literally empty, which was perfect for me. A short sail, roughly about 25 minutes. Now, if you don't know what an artificial reef is basically a man-made structure which has been sunk on purpose to create an artificial reef. Now, before these vessels or planes are sunk, all the wires, all the oils have been taken off and drained and then sunk to create an artificial reef. Sometimes to distract divers to dive on other corals and to make it like a tourist attraction as well. So on this first dive, we'll be diving on the SG-115 wreck, which is an old Coast Guard ship, which was sunk in 2007 to be an artificial reef. This artificial reef lies between 19 to 24 meters. If you've got experience enough, you can penetrate this wreck, but you've got to look inside before you actually enter, because you've got to keep your eye out for the old lionfish, as they sometimes are well camouflaged. As I mentioned before, all the cables, oils and parts of the engine compartment has been taken away. All the wiring, anything that could potentially trap any divers has been dismantled and taken away. As I said before, you stick your head in or actually go in the compartment, just keep an eye out for these lionfish like this one. They just sit, they don't move. Just watch out for them. As we come across the starboard side, you see like a mount where they probably had mounted a machine gun, probably to give warning shots or as a deterrent to any smugglers. And can open boxes, who knows, that could have been where they store the ammunition. Here you can see my guide having a quick look inside before he enters, before I enter as well, to make sure there's no of those crafty lionfish. You don't want them landing on you or you put your hand on anything. As you can see, there's nothing in the sort of control area. As I mentioned before, everything's been taken out, all the control panels, as again not to have any entrapment for any divers. So we're coming to the stern of this vessel. It's been great for if you're just into diving or just want to see a wreck or an artificial reef. Nothing too stressful, nice and easy. You can stick your head in if you don't want to actually enter the actual boat yourself. As I said before, watch out for those lionfish. Max depth 19 to 24 meters. So this was day one of my two dives diving. The second dive was like a scenic dive. So on the next day, I dived another artificial reef. This time it was a plane, which is a Charlie 47 Dakota, which was part of the Turkish Air Force. I believe it was sunk in 2007. The depth range is between maybe 24 to 32 meters. The tail end of this plane is at 32 meters. Over time, I think due to storms, it has broken up, which will make its benefit because it actually can get a good look in the cabin area or cockpit area of this plane. You can't really appreciate the size of this on this video, but when I saw it was quite impressive. It's pretty big, a nice little artificial reef. Again, keep your eye out for those lionfish, they are everywhere. Right, so that's the end of the two artificial reefs. I hope you enjoyed that. So if you're ever in Turkey, Gambon or Gambet, go and check out Happy Bubbles Dive Center. Very accommodating, very helpful, very cheery bunch. So this was around the beginning of June. Water temperature was about 19 degrees. I think I was very lucky because it was literally me and another diver on this dive, and the water and viz was nice and clear. So if you like this video, please give us a thumbs up, it'd be appreciated. And in the comments, please leave a comment below. And if you haven't already, please consider subscribing, it'd be really much appreciated. So a couple other dives, unfortunately not overseas. I've got another dive coming up in Scotland soon, and I'll upload any other dive related videos I can think of. So keep your eye on that. Okay, thanks for watching, and as always, see you on the next one.